Gotta be getting close. Whoa! Undead samurais now? Wow. Lobster. I'm cool with some lobster bisque, whatever.
Josh is like, next up, somebody pizza cat crows.
Oh! Stabbed in the nuts! And it's not okay!
I mean, it's better than you having your chestnuts roasted over an open flame.
I could not understand that either!
Alright, give me a minute.
Let's see here. Well, shit.
Let's see if that's any better.
That actually sounds better already. And then I lost you. Now it's just me.
What I did was I took it out of the front spot and put them in the back one.
Ah.
See if that would do any better.
It sounds somewhat better.
That's good.
Let's see. Oh, damn! Shot me in the shin.
Akame Tensei?
Oh, see, I understood that. That's...
Drax says you shot off your pinky toe.
Fudge, I did the same thing twice. Do I not learn?
Get back to me when you do it thrice. I put it on ice.
That's not nice.
Maybe share it with some mice?
Maybe I'll eat it over rice. Not again. The true weakness of the ninja, their shins and ankles.
I thought it was guns.
Seems like that too.
Jeez, I'm crow.
Spick spack, this thing is whack.
Did we make this into Paratha?
Punch, kick, it's all in the mind. If you wish to test me, I'm sure you'll find the things I teach you are sure to beat you, but nevertheless, you get a lesson from teacher.
Nice.
I think I felt. I honestly think Ninja Gaiden is less frustrating than this game.
Nah, I think it depends on if you're up against the birds or not.
I don't remember getting this frustrated when I beat Ninja Gaiden. I could be wrong.
I don't know, it's been a while since I've watched it.
You're probably right, Kyo. Yes, Robbie. Yes, Pemmy. Jump into the bullet. That'll save you.
It won't?
Oh, gosh. Shut. Oh, come on! Ah! This is the pits!
Well, hopefully not the armpits.
Ooh. Joe Musashi is not a fan of that fetish, sir.
I don't know anybody who is.
I have seen multiples. Oh, you must! I just got the gun! This game!
I just wanted a gun!
It's all fun when you got the gun.
Yeah, it really is.
Well, that guy just lopped my head off.
Well, you weren't using it anyway.
Yeah, you know. It's just there for decoration.
Yep.
Hey, Kyo, since you're in the chat, I got a question for you. Are any of the Genesis, any of the Genesis Shinobi games worth playing? Let's see. I also know in Shadow Dancer, you're not saving kids, you're instead getting rid of bombs, if I remember right.
So long as we're not, you know, going underwater into electrified seaweed to disable the bombs.
Let's see. Okay, so Kyo says yes, they are. What's your opinion on Shadow Dancer, Arcade, and Genesis, Kyo? Son of a shit fuck!
I'm not sure she's worth it, Drax. Electrified seaweed? I mean, come on! Drax is like, hey, you need to do that. It's a BS level to save a reporter. He says it's the arcade one is this, but more badass since it has a ninja wolf.
Yeah, that's a Shadow Dancer. Yeah. And I know the Genesis version's different, but I don't know how different or...
I like how we keep using the word different in different tones.
Well, no, it's like practically a different game with the same ideas from my understanding on that
right.
one.
Right.
Ah!
It's different?
Well, Drax is like, why can't Shinobi, or in this case, the guy's name is Joe Musashi, can't wall jump, and he missed that day of ninja school. Also, his ankles are weak. We've been seeing how he dies by just being shot in the ankle, so.
Well, you know how you're told we should never skip leg day? Well, he skipped wall jump day.
Alright, I'll keep that in mind, Kyo. I know Revenge of Shinobi has the the unlicensed guest appearance of Batman, depending on which version you're playing. Oh! I also noticed that my score doesn't reset when I continue. That's interesting for an arcade game. Mm-hmm. Most will, like, reset your score when you do that.
Like Knuckles, he skipped leg day. Drax is like, no, Pim, it's Man of Bats.
That's right. Ah, that was a dumb move on my part. Man, oh man. What ninja would be called named Joe anyways? Is Joe Musashi not full Asian? Is he not full Japanese? Is he like half American?
He is a big fan of Bionic Commando.
Bionic Commando has a Joe?
Yeah. Sniper Joe, I think.
Sniper Joe's a character in Mega Man.
I know there's a Joe in freaking Bionic Commando. It's just been years.
Ah!
Has that played the original?
You mean Bionic Commando? Wait. Yes. Yeah, you said Bionic. You mean Super Joe?
Yeah, there we go.
You said Bionic Commando, and for some weird reason, my brain was filling in with Bionic 6, and I don't know why. Yeah, Super Joe is a character from. It's a character you save in Bionic Commando.
Well, you know, you can be a fan of that guy.
He's actually the name of a character in multiple games. I know it's Super Joe is the name of the guy in Commando, the original Commando. He's in Arcade Bionic Commando, but not in the NES version. Mm-hmm. Hey, you're back!
Yeah, I had to take care of some things.
Ah.
I thought everything's right as rain.
Alrighty. I was a little worried about you.
Used to Pim's garbage.
You are a raccoon, after all.
Yep.
I was a little worried because you just kind of suddenly left. So.
Sorry for making you worry.
It's all right.
You're here now, so he's less worried.
Those guys are very weird. Why are they hopping? Why do they hop like frogs?
I don't know. They're like those fleamen from Oh, you son of a!
I guess my best guess is they're based on like whatever Chinese vampires are called. They're known for like hopping like that.
Yeah. I don't know. They remind me of the fleamen from Castlevania.
Drax says Joe's nationality is Japanese American.
Really? Neat. So he's half American ninja.
that explains why he uses a gun.
Actually, yes.
Non-American culture.
I hate to say it, but yeah.
In America, we substitute. In America, we use other weapons besides normal ninja weaponry. we thought, what's an upgrade from a throwing star? A gun!
A gun! This game is getting quite frustrating, I will be honest.
Yeah. Well, it doesn't surprise me. Arcades and all.
Yeah. But so far, I'm finding this more frustrating than when I beat Ninja Gaiden. But I don't know. Not all arcade games are frustrating. I mean, we've played through quite a few of those fairly quickly, usually.
Mushroom does say something that that the whole many of the hard games that we know of came from an era that really tried to milk difficulty as a way to extend play time, whether it be for getting more quarters in the machine or for home releases, making it so you'd be less likely to trade it in or something, because if you rent it, it's more incentive to either keep renting it or buy it fully.
Yeah. Oh, lordy.
I mostly avoided that era growing up, and especially I didn't play a lot of arcades, and I think I ended some N64 games, but that was about it. Dang.
I'm sure in some language that meant something, and I hope it was vile.
Also, are all these bosses in the title cards, are they all named after animals?
No.
I saw turtle for that helicopter and lobster for the...
Yeah, lobster's the current one. The helicopter was called turtle, but the first one was called Ken-O, so... I don't know. And I don't remember what the last one was called. I don't know. Let's see. Lobster's a really... I don't know. A dumb ninja code name, in my opinion. And that guy just jumped right off the ledge.
Character decked out in similar armor and Fire Emblem 8-8. So it was a fandom joke of him looking like a
lobster
or something.
That's actually pretty good. Ooh, that's a game I should play sometime. I actually got that translated version of the first Fire Emblem game. Or first two Fire Emblem games, I think it was.
Yeah. I wonder what you'd think of old school Fire Emblem, before all the streamlined features and all the modern stuff like supports and shipping and all.
I don't know, because I've actually never played a Fire Emblem game.
Yeah.
Oh, so what you're saying is it's Shining Force before Fire Emblem became a major thing.
See, I've actually never technically I've played one Fire Emblem game, and I don't think it counts. And the only Fire Emblem game I played was the cell phone one they had.
Well, hey, if it's officially called Fire Emblem and it plays like Fire Emblem, I'd say it counts.
All right. But yeah, I got those I got those, and at some point whenever I want to try to hook up my video capture card again, I guess I can try streaming that. I've heard the first one is kind of rough. Then again, so is what I'm playing. But yeah, I've never played any of the actual not mobile Fire Emblem games. I've heard they're good. I've just never gotten around to playing them. Mostly because I rarely have the time to play anything that's an RPG, because RPGs are long.
Yeah. Well, since it's like a Nest era one, it likely won't be very. It won't be that long.
Yeah, that's part of the reason why I'm thinking I might give it a try and might stream it. Because yeah.
You've ever obviously never touched Legacy of the Wizard.
Oh, that game. Legacy of the Wizard. That game's. It's got problems, and its length isn't the issue. I can deal with 23 hours for an RPG. I can deal with that. It'd take quite a few streams, but I mean, I can deal with that. That seems a feasible beat to me. It's when they get into like 80 hours that I have a problem.
Yeah, tough. RPGs that are that long can be a bit of a tricky sell. Like, in theory, that can mean a huge story and plenty of content, but I could also mean like the content is padded out to hell to try and justify putting 80 hours long on the back of a box or something.
Yeah, 80 hours. Go ahead. Sorry.
So you'd have to kind of look into like when it says how long a game is like. You'd also have to look into like how much of it is like fresh content and how much is like repetitive or stretched out or whatnot.
Yeah, because from my understanding, 80 hours is like the norm for a lot of RPGs these days. Oh, God, I didn't mean to actually do this.
Well, it's got you out of a bind.
Yeah.
I haven't really played a whole lot of RPGs myself. I played Pokemon up until fairly recently because I haven't been into Pokemon. And I also played like Xenoblade Chronicles X on the Wii U, and I tried some Deltarune, and I remember playing a GameCube Lord of the Rings RPG with my brother a few times.
Shit. Sorry.
But I don't really have much else experience with RPGs, so most of what I know of like RPGs, I tend to like hear offhand or read about out the M, or maybe see a little playthroughs of the M online or something.
Makes sense. Yeah, I mean, if there is, Pokemon is like the one RPG I still play, but that's also because since it's like meant as an RPG for like kids, it's a lot shorter.
Yeah, it's certainly easier, and I guess I can understand why. I remember losing my enthusiasm for Pokemon, partly because like it started feel like there was less like. Of a content or approach for like people who are more experienced. Like there's like the battle tower alone just doesn't really cut it for me, and especially with the sort of like Pokemon hasn't really done much in the way of innovation, especially with the way they cut out a large amount of the DX early on it, and yet, the way the game still like sold phenomenally despite like the backlash against that and things like that, it just gave me the impression that Pokemon doesn't really have to try very hard because they'll know they'll sell anyway. And I feel like Pokemon's kind of rested on its
laurels,
so it's a little hard for me to like. Yeah, you got through that.
I can understand that because I know around. I had a bit of a Pokemon burnout at one point. Because I didn't get all the way through, Diamond and Pearl, because I just felt burnt out during that game.
Yeah.
Black and White renewed that interest, though.
That particular game did have, like, very awkward, like, long save times, which Platinum fixed. Yeah, at the end of the day, there are still plenty of things I like. About Pokemon, I like most of the monster designs. I like the battle system, at least the theory of it, and I like a lot of the songs. Yeah. So So I can still, like, I still, like, generally keep up with Pokemon news, listen to songs, look at arts and stuff, but I'll probably, but as for, like, playing the actual games, I'm at least waiting until, like, I see a game that, like, I really feel, like, a sense of wow again. I trust that will really, it'll be a game that I can get hooked on.
Makes sense. Let's see. Oh, for fuck's sake. this game.
Mm-hmm. What other games did Shinobi get as a series?
There's Shadow Dancer on the arcade, which I've never played. I saw it in the arcade as a kid, but in that, it's pretty much like this one, except you also have a dog or a wolf.
Oh yeah, the one you said it was hard for you to play because the dog kept getting hurt.
Yeah, I saw the dog get hurt in, like, I didn't play it, but I watched, like, the demo where it shows you the, you know, pretty much the game, and I saw the dog get hurt, and I was just like, nope. Because I was a sensitive kid.
Yeah.
Humans being hurt, I'm fine with that. Dogs, not so much.
you probably shouldn't watch JoJo.
I want to know what dog bit Oroki and Araki, or yeah, I think it's his name, Araki. I want to know what dog bit Araki and why he hasn't gotten over it. fortunately, as an adult, I don't like seeing dogs get hurt still, but I can, you know, separate fact from fiction a lot better than I could when I was a kid. It doesn't bother me. Though I actually read what Araki's explanation for all the animal abuse in JoJo was, and I can get behind his logic, which is he'd have bad guys, you know, hurt or kill dogs because only an evil person would do that to a dog.
Yeah, even though, like, considering, like, that's a rather, like, a bit of a trite way to do, like, a literal dog kicking is, like, how very on the nose.
Yeah, I mean, but God, man,
I think at the least he could, like, mix it up with what animal oles the bad guys kick.
Yeah,
maybe they kick gerbil oles or goldfish.
Well, sadly, from someone who's seen JoJo, I can say that and it's more than just kicking; it's full out, you know, dog murder.
Well, kicking's more of like a metaphor.
What in the heck?
Is that a bird in a super suit?
It was. It was a crow. What in the hell? Jeez, some crow indeed.
If it was a crow, wouldn't it be have black feathers? What I saw looked more like yellow suit. It's red lobster time.
Wow, that was just straight up. He just straight up fucking stabbed me.
Yeah, taste the wrath of my stunt doubles. Man, that guy's relentless. How are you supposed to dodge a guy you can't jump over or even slow down?
Okay, so I was told by Kyo for the sake of all that is holy, save state now, so, all right.
Oh, Kyo, apparently after you beat this boss, You lose the ability to get, you stop getting checkpoints.
Yeah. Or which, save, you can't continue any longer, I think.
Yeah, good old dickish past game mentality, so yeah.
Actually,
you live in a time of save space.
Actually, honestly, for an arcade game, that's a weird choice, since the idea is to usually, a lot of them usually would have unlimited continues because, you know, that keeps you putting quarters in. Taking that out kind of doesn't really encourage to keep putting quarters in. That seems like a really weird decision.
Yeah, the most I can see, yeah, all mostly just seems to do is like promote like a bit like a pro mentality, like you're not good enough to get down there, therefore you deserve to
start all over,
which is bit good old snobbery.
Yeah, I can't say I'm a fan of that logic. All right, so let's save here, and time to